You've seen this one before, right? Yeah, it's the other guy doing proportions and ratios. I got the sound turned down because this dude's better seen, not heard. I mean, he's good looking and all that, but his voice is really annoying. I watched this video all the way through and I kept thinking, what is he doing? Proportions? It says convert right there. He should be using conversion factors. So I slipped up here in his studio so I could show you how to knock these off with conversion factors. So, same problem here, $1 worth 80 Japanese yen. This dude Will's going off to Japan, and he's gonna need 60,000 yen while he's there. How many dollars is that? We're gonna start off by building our conversion factor. $1 is 80 Japanese yen, and we wanna take the 60,000 yen, and we wanna convert that into dollars. Now I'm going to need a conversion factor with the Japanese yen in the denominator to cancel with this. So I'm going to divide both sides of this by 80 Japanese yen, and I'm going to have $1 over 80 Japanese yen equals 1. That's my conversion factor. I can just multiply our 60,000 yen by this. And sure enough, I've got yen in the numerator and in the denominator. They cancel out. I'm left with 60,000 divided by 80 US dollars. 60,000 divided by 80 is a factor of 10. Obviously, I can take off a zero. I've got 6,000 divided by 8. That's the same thing as 6/8 times 1,000 US dollars. 6/8, of course, that's 3/4. 3/4 of 1,000, that's 750 US dollars. Conversion problems, just crush that problem. Now let's try another one. I love this problem. This was my favorite problem. This is one. Remember this problem? Other guy explained how his mom, even his mom, was trying to send him 1,000 miles away. That's so awesome. Even his mom was trying to get rid of him. All right, so here's the problem. How far apart are Decatur and Princeton? I also like this problem because, you know, other guy explained he went to high school in Decatur. I went to high school in Decatur. And he went to college at Princeton. Woo hoo hoo! I went to college at Princeton too, and I did at least as well as he did. So we have to figure out how far apart Decatur and Princeton are. Now, on this map, they're 20 inches apart. They're 20 inches from Decatur down here, Princeton up there. Now, this map has a scale down here. It says 2.5 inches on the map. 2.5 inches on the map is 100 miles. That's a conversion factor. We can solve this problem with conversion factors. We've got 2.5 map inches is 100 real miles. Now, on the map, these two places are 20 inches apart. So we've got 20 map inches. So we're going to multiply by a conversion factor that has map inches in the denominator. So we're going to divide up here both sides by 2.5 map inches, and that will give us our conversion factor of 100 real miles for every 2.5 map inches. And of course, the map inches cancel out, and we get 20 times 100 over 2.5 real miles. 20 times 100, that's 2,000, so we've got 2,000 over 2.5. I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by 2 to get rid of that decimal. That's going to give me 4,000 over 5 miles. 4,000 divided by 5, of course, that is 800 miles. Conversion factors for the win.